if you've heard of anything that I do directly, it may be that you've seen announcements about the discovery of an object called the Higgs boson. And this is a very important scientific discovery, maybe one of the 10 most important of this century, for example. It's fun to talk about with our students. It's a very exciting thing. As a scientist, it's very satisfying that humanity collectively knows a little bit more about nature today than we did yesterday. If we're doing that in science, we're doing okay. I and some of my colleagues at Kansas State perform research at the world's most powerful particle accelerator. It's called the Large Hadron Collider, or the LHC. It's located in Geneva, Switzerland, and this is something that many students know about. It's often a topic on shows like The Big Bang Theory on commercial television that's very popular. We put 8 graduate students in Junction City High School classrooms every year. It lets us connect these graduate students and their day-to-day research with activities in this very valuable community that's right next door to us that serves the Army and Fort Riley and others. And I'm also involved in a more specific outreach program related to high energy physics called QuarkNet. This connects with a lot of small high schools all over the state. And we typically have workshops where we have a couple of dozen high school teachers come in a few times a year to K-State. And sometimes we actually go out and see them, and we tell them a little bit about high energy physics, and we talk about ways they can incorporate this physics and this new knowledge into their classrooms. 2 of our junior faculty members in the high energy group have won very important awards from the Department of Energy recognizing their science. So I think I get the sense that this is exactly what President Schultz and the provost and others want us to be engaged in 2025. They want us to just keep getting better and keep pushing harder. And we're very happy to do that.